The President, please be seated.
Vous asseoir.
The chair
is now in session. All parties are present.
Toutes les parties sont présentes.
The survivor, who is also a civil party, is also present for today's testimony.
La partie civile qui doit comparaître aujourd'hui est également présente.
Montrey Tolaka, une
court officer.
Le président.
Can you invite the civil party, Chum Mey, into the courtroom?
Monsieur Chum Mey.
The President, Uncle, what is your name?
Comment vous appelez-vous?
My name is Chum Mey.
Je m'appelle Chum Mey.
Question.
Question.
Do you have any other names besides Chum Mey?
Avez-vous un autre nom que celui de Chum Mey?
So your official name is Mang, not Mei.
Votre nom à l'état civil est
so
Mang.
Your official name
et non
is
pas
Chum
Mei.
Mang.
Votre
and
nom
Mei
à
is
l'état
your
civil
alias.
Est
is this
Chum
correct?
Mang. Et vous portez sinon le pseudonyme de Chum Mei, est-ce exact?
Mr. President, the honors,
la partie civile, Monsieur le Président, Mesdames, Messieurs les juges,
both national and international judges,
nationaux et internationaux,
and my respects to all the lawyers and the co-prosecutors and also the civil parties lawyers,
les avocats et les parties civiles.
My respect also to
je
the noble monks,
mes respects,
both and as well as national and international
ainsi
audience,
qu'au public cambodgien et étranger.
President.
Le président.
How old are you this year, Uncle?
Quel âge avez-vous cette année, monsieur?
I am 79
réponse.
Years old, says Chum Mey.
J'ai 79 ans.
Question.
Question.
What is your current address?
Quelle est votre adresse actuelle?
I live at Stung Min Jai Quarter, Stung Min Jai District.
J'habite au district de.
Questioned, What is your current occupation?
Question, quelle est votre occupation actuellement? Réponse.
I do not work at the moment.
Je ne travaille plus. Question.
Regarding this criminal case filed, you lodged your application as a civil
Vous êtes
party,
constitué partie civile dans la présente
and
affaire.
The question is, do you seek reparation for
Je voudrais
yourself,
savoir si vous demandez réparation pour vous-même,
or do you waive your right to your lawyer to seek
ou
for
si
reparation on your behalf?
Vous laissez à vos avocats le soin de demander réparation
I
en votre nom.
My application.
Réponse. Je me suis
and regarding the reparation, I gave the right to my
Et
lawyer to act on my behalf.
Je donne pouvoir
Question.
À mes avocats d'agir en mon nom.
As a civil
Question.
Party, what is your connection to the facts alleged?
Vous êtes partie civile.
To the
Quel est votre lien avec les faits reprochés à l'accusé?
Response.
Réponse.
I am involved with the facts because the accused
Je suis,
alleged that I was part of a CIA or KGB network.
Car l'accusé m'a accusé d'être un agent de la CIA.
Question. So the fact
Question.
On the accused is related to the S21 security office.
C'est fait.
Or
et vos griefs ont donc trait
to the
au bureau de sécurité S21 ou au camp de rééducation de Pressor?
Response.
Réponse.
It is related to S21 or Toolsline.
Les faits dont je suis victime ont à voir avec S21 ou Toolsline.
Is it your direct involvement as a victim there or
avez-vous été victime directe?
Relatives.
De ce qui s'est passé
is it both your involvement and your relatives' involvement?
Est-ce que ce sont des parents qui ont été victimes ou les deux? Réponse.
I and my family decided to make application to be a civil party.
Ma famille et moi-même avons décidé
case.
De nous porter partie civile dans la présente affaire.
Question. The question,
question.
Is whether you yourself directly
si suffered vous avez été
from the
victime
act
directe
alleged
des
in
faits
the facts.
Reprochés à l'accusé.
Uncle, before the 17th April,
Monsieur, avant le 17 avril 1975,
where did you live and what was
où
your
viviez-vous
occupation?
Et quelle était votre profession?
Response.
Réponse.
Before 1975,
avant le 17 avril 1975,
I was a mechanic fixing
tractors, je
réparais cars,
des tracteurs, des
example.
Voitures, par exemple.
And where was you at the time? In Phnom Penh.
Question. Où était-ce? Réponse.
Chum Mey.
À Phnom Penh.
Question.
Question.
And on the 17th April 1975, when the Khmer Rouge soldiers
entered
Phnom Penh,
sont entrés à Phnom Penh,
where were you and what were you doing?
Où étiez-vous et que faisiez-vous?
Response.
Réponse.
In 1974, I was in Phnom Penh.
En 1974, j'étais à Phnom Penh.
Montrai de la carte et le micro va
court. Court officer. That is okay.
Om sua tha ថ្ងៃ ទី 17 ខែ មេសាឆ្នាំ
1975
ការមុនហ្នឹងអ៊ំបានឆ្លើយរួចហើយ hay tala ka mình chong đăng ba man đi chong đăng nưng kư vấn hà thông khăn
rahot
đọ pẹp pon chmuay nưng mnti san sop so 21
ti ban
dai
dai
mai ban
yul chi vi phiep roba om nưng
chap pi ngai 17 khai mesa chan 75 nưng rahot đọ
from the 17th April 75
đọ thngai ti 7 khai mekara chnam 79 nưng
vi min However, there would be stages that they would question you.
À la question concernant
so first of all, we want to know on the 17th April 1975,
nous voudrions
where
aussi
you?
Savoir pour commencer
and what did you
où
do?
Vous étiez le 17 avril 1975. Où étiez-vous et que faisiez-vous ce jour-là?
Chum Mey.
Réponse.
In 1975, on that day, I
le
was with the prince Chang Rangsei at
Chiba Mon
in Kampong Speu province.
Dans la province de Kampong Speu.
Actually, in 1974, Chang Rangsei had me transferred to Phnom Penh.
Le prince Chang Rangsei m'avait
so I was taken by a helicopter from
Chiba
Mon to Phnom Penh, and he advised me that I should go home for now, and if I needed you, I would call you back.
Et qu'il me rappellerait s'il avait besoin de moi.
The President, we want to know the event on the 17th April 1975 when the Khmer Rouge entered Phnom Penh. What did you do and where were you at the time?
Qu'avez-vous fait ce jour-là et où étiez-vous?
Let me continue and I will reach that point. When I entered Phnom Penh, the Khmer Rouge were sailing
Phnom Penh,
from Prasat, from Vihisu into Phnom Penh,
la ville,
also
depuis l'extérieur,
from Tak Mau into Phnom Penh. So a lot of locations were burned in Tak Lao, for example. So the sailing was from every direction.
De bâtiments étaient brûlés.
At that time,
ces
the Khmer Rouge entered at 8 o'clock in the morning.
Khmer Rouge sont arrivés
and
à Phnom Penh,
I was near the vicinity of
Moi,
Psa Depot at the time.
À proximité du marché qui s'appelle Psa Depot.
When the Khmer Rouge entered, some female soldiers
Quand les Khmer Rouge sont arrivés,
came into the city with one of the trouser sleeves pulled up and carrying the B-40 rocket launcher.
Avec
the question is, so you were in Phnom Penh on that day, right?
Question. Donc vous étiez à Phnom Penh ce jour-là,
and were you evacuated by the Khmer Rouge force on the day or when?
Rouge ce jour-là,
and which direction were you
jour,
evacuated et to?
Dans quelle direction avez-vous été évacué?
Chum Mey.
Réponse.
Mr. President, when they entered, everybody, including myself,
tout le monde, y compris moi-même,
raised a white flag to congratulate them. Everybody cheered.
A été à la rencontre des soldats
However,
qui m'ont rouge avec des drapeaux blancs pour
les féliciter. PM,
Mais
they
l'après-midi,
walked
Vers
from house to house and informed us that we had to leave Phnom Penh 5 kilometers away from Phnom Penh because the Americans were about to bomb the city.
Les Américains s'apprêtaient à bombarder la ville.
Question. So the Khmer Rouge evacuated to you?
Donc,
to which
Khmer
direction?
Vous ont évacué. Quelle direction avez-vous prise?
So at that time, some people refused to leave, and the Khmer Rouge shot them. Two or three of those people fell on the ground. I was scared, so I collected my family, and then we moved. We went near toward the Pet Luk Song Hospital, and the road was so full.
La route était pleine
we could hardly walk.
On pouvait à peine marcher.
And we reached Takla.
Nous sommes arrivés à Takla.
It was near dusk already.
Il faisait
so
déjà presque nuit.
So I rested near the cultural area for one night.
Pour une nuit.
Later on, I made my journey.
Plus tard, nous avons repris notre voyage.
To Prey Pneu. And when we reached
Prey Pneu,
it was night time. And since I could not find any water in order to cook rice, so I took my children and my wife to stay near the riverbank in order to get some water. And at that time, because it was dark, I stepped on dead bodies along the riverbank. So after I cooked a meal, we ate, and then we rested. And at 4 p.m., we were chased again to move on. So we continued our journey. On the left side, there was a pond, a fish pond. But because the fish did not have anything to eat, and I saw the bloated dead bodies in the pond, and the fish was eating those dead bodies.
Il y avait des cadavres so along déjà gonflés the road from Pneu,
we
finalement
saw
stacks
of dead bodies
et là, nous avons encore vu
everywhere.
Des piles de cadavres partout.
And so you reach what
Question.
Group? Where was it? Chum Mey. It's near Prek Dam.
Où est cet endroit?
So we
Réponse.
Continue the journey and we were
Nous
asked to cross the river
continué.
To the east side of the river.
Le fleuve vers le, vers
that
l'est.
Night it rained
ce soir-là, il a
and
plu.
One of my children got a diarrhea and a high fever.
La diarrhée et une
And I did not have any medicine for him.
Je n'avais aucun médicament avec moi pour le soigner.
So I went to ask for medicine from Onka.
Des médicaments à l'Ankar.
And I walked to find Onkar, but I could not find any Onkar.
Je n'ai trouvé personne.
So when I asked to see Onkar, I was told to move on, but I could not find who was Onkar. And as a result, my son died.
Et mon enfant est ainsi mort.
Then I borrowed a hole,
j'ai creusé
and then
un trou,
I dug the ground and buried my son. He
et
was
j'ai enterré
2 years old at
mon
the time.
Fils, il avait 2 ans.
Later on, we continued our
Ensuite, nous
journey.
Avons poursuivi ce voyage.
It was difficult for us because there was no shelter or shade for us to rest.
Du soleil.
And under each tree, people
et en dessous de chaque arbre,
just gathered around to make big crowd. So it was so hard, so miserable.
De gens. C'était extrêmement pénible.
And we continued our journey until
nous sommes finalement arrivés à
near Tnok, and we were stopped there.
Et là, nous sommes arrêtés.
I didn't know what else to do, and then
je ne savais pas quoi
we
faire.
Were ordered to go behind the Chung Knok Pagoda,
d'aller derrière
and
la
we were
pagode
asked to stay
de
Chung temporarily.
Et d'y rester
we
temporairement.
We stayed there, and on that night it rained
ce
again,
il a
so
une fois plu.
We stayed under the house of the
nous
local
nous
villagers.
Dans les maisons des villageois.
In the next morning,
le matin
I went
suivant,
to the rice fields to find food, looking for crabs.
À manger, je cherchais des crabes.
Then I saw a bus.
Puis j'ai vu un bus.
And an announcement was made
et,
through a loudspeaker,
quelqu'un
looking
a
for
a
any mechanics.
Par haut-parleur qu'on cherchait
that
des mécaniciens.
Onkar is looking for a mechanic to go and work in Phnom Penh.
Pour travailler à Phnom Penh.
So I told them that I was a mechanic, then I was given a letter of authorization.
Alors, un laissez-passer.
So with that letter of authorization, I saw the people
Avec
who
ce laissez-passer,
was in charge there, and I was told that I should not go during the day, but I should go in late afternoon.
Je me suis mis en route, m'a dit de ne pas
so
me
in late
en route,
afternoon,
dans la
we
journée,
left,
de partir en fin d'après-midi.
And when
c'est
we
ce que
reached Prek Dam, I handed the paper to the chief
Prek
there,
Dam, et là, j'ai
and I was told
cette
to wait there until
locales,
there would be more mechanics coming.
Que d'autres mécaniciens arrivent
so
aussi.
Together, there were 7 mechanics,
Au total,
including
il y avait,
Ta Jin, Ta Sun,
Ta Peng,
and the 7 of us.
Au total, 7 Personne, sept mécaniciens,
were asked to come to Phnom Penh.
qu'on a emmené à Phnom Penh.
And I asked, what about my family?
J'ai dit, et ma famille?
And I was told, don't worry about the family. They can't stay here and Onka would look after your family. So I bought the boat.
Nous sommes donc montés dans un bateau. And we traveled on the boat. Nous sommes
and we got off the boat in Rusaikail, and I showed the letter to Comrade Sruer, who was in charge of boat repair section there. So in the morning, the seven of us were asked to fix the boats. From what I can recall, we fixed more than 10 boats.
Et pour autant que je me souviens, nous avons réparé une dizaine. Après avoir fini,
then the soldiers were loaded full on each boat,
ont utilisé
and the boats departed to Krachet province.
Et sont partis sur ces embarcations vers Krachet.
And later on, I was asked if I could fix
si
or repair a tractor or a car,
ou une voiture.
And I told them yes,
je
I could fix
oui.
Tractors and cars. And Comrade Sru asked whether I could drive them as well, and I told him yes.
J'ai dit que oui.
Then I was asked to drive the bulldozer into the ferry and another vehicle into the ferry.
De le faire monter
and
sur
those
le ferry.
Vehicles were sent to Krachet province.
Et puis encore un autre, et ces deux,
so I was also asked to board the ferry in order to drive the tractor and the tracks on the other side of the riverbank, and next day I returned.
Sur l'autre rive du fleuve. Le jour suivant, je suis rentré.
So when I returned to my work location, then I was requested
sur le travail, et là, on m'a demandé
if I knew all the pieces
si
or spare pieces of the tractor, and when they knew I knew, then I was transferred to Rusai.
J'ai dit que oui, on m'a transféré
so
à
when we were at the Rusai camp, there were six of us,
là,
but when I
six,
was transferred to Rusai,
au premier
I was
endroit,
instructed
six,
to collect
quand j'étais transféré
the tools
à Orusei,
from
on m'a dit de
the houses in order to put them in the warehouse.
Des instruments, des
then
outils
Comrade
Kun dans les maisons
asked me whether I could fix the
à l'entrepôt.
Loudspeaker,
et ensuite, on m'a demandé si
and
je
I told him yes.
Les haut-parleurs. J'ai dit
so
que
I was asked to repair the loudspeakers in the middle of the Orusei market.
Dans le marché de Orusei.
So I fixed those loudspeakers for about 3 or 4 months, and later on we were told that we no longer needed to collect those tools. Instead, Onka required us to collect sewing machines in order to sew black clothes. So we collected sewing machines. Altogether, we collected 17,000 sewing machines. And after that, we saw women who came to that factory to sew the black clothes. There were about 1,000 women and roughly 200 men to the sewing machine factory. So we started working there from 75 until 77 and in 1978. This is, I just briefly summarized the event. I was ordered to repair vehicles in Vietnam. That's what I was told.
En tout cas, c'est ce qu'on m'a dit.
But before they told me that, Comrade Kun, who was my boss, was already arrested.
Mon chef
and then
Chum
came to replace him.
Il avait été remplacé
and a few months later,
Chum
was arrested
tard, Chum était arrêté
and replaced by Comrade Jung. I was not sure, but according to Dutch Comrade Jung, or another Jung,
ou peut-être un autre Jung,
was in charge of that location.
Était responsable
and after Jung disappeared,
cet endroit, Jung a disparu
another
son
female
tour,
from Takeo,
named
Van,
qui s'appelait
came
Van.
To replace at that location, which was called Go Nang.
À l'usine, qui
and also another comrade, Lim came to work in that
Lim
location.
Qui est venu travailler
and that
là.
Was the time that I was called an instructed to go and repair vehicles because Angkor plans to attack Vietnam. So the three of us did not object and we volunteered to go. And in the morning, we carried the tools to depart from Konang in a Lambretta. However, we were told that we did not need to bring the tools. We just go by ourselves. So we boarded the Lambretta.
Nous avons donc monté sur la Lambretta.
And along the way, I did not know that because I saw the fence of the zinc fence.
Je voyais,
I could not see what was inside.
Une clôture de zinc. Je pouvais pas
so
voir
we
ce
were
à
brought into tool slang.
C'est ainsi qu'on nous a
but
fait
I did not know that place was called tool slang at the time. Later on, we were put into the house which was
oui,
opposite tool slang.
Dans une maison en face de
once we disembarked from Lambretta, we
quand
were arrested and handcuffed, and our scarf on our neck
on nous a mis un
was
bandeau.
Used to blindfold
on utilisait notre cramin pour nous bander les yeux.
And then we walked inside the compound.
Nous sommes ainsi entrés
while
dans
I was walking, I told the person that brother, please look after
et
my family.
Dit,
then that person
si vous de ma famille,
kicked me, and I fell on the ground.
Ça, m'a donné des
and he said,
par terre.
You motherfucker, Angkor needs to smash you all. You don't need to think about your family.
Tu n'as pas à penser à ta famille.
Then I was taken into the room and my height was taken and I was photographed.
On m'a délié les mains et on a pris ma photo.
I was so... The method used was so hot. It was always hot. Not coal method or
la
other method as Dutch
brutale.
Claimed.
We
were scolded,
we
were
chaude,
called contemptible this or contemptible that.
On nous appelait toujours
and
méprisables
they asked me about my biography and I told him I was from Kampong Luwia commune, Kampong Trabai district and Preveng province.
De la province de
then they took my photographs. And they took my shirt off and my pants off. I only hid my shorts.
Je n'avais plus qu'un short.
And my shoes were also
on
taken
aussi
away.
Souliers.
And my hands were cuffed to the back.
On m'a lié
and I was blindfolded.
Dans le dos. On m'a remis un bandeau
then
sur les
they
yeux.
Walked me
et on m'a fait marcher
to the location where I was detained, and actually I told the co-investigating judges of that location already. So I was placed into that cell, they shackled my legs, then they took off the cuffs and unblindfolded me. Then they used a piece of cloth to conceal the cell. And I could see the guards walking up and down the corridor.
Masquer la cellule, mais je pouvais voir les gardiens qui marchaient le long du couloir.
And at about 1 o'clock,
vers une heure,
then a person came to cuff my hands to the back, blindfolded me, and then they unshackled my legs.
Et a libéré ma jambe.
Then the person pulled my earlobe to stand up.
Puis il m'a tiré par l'oreille pour que je me lève.
And I was walked to the
stairs.
And then they pulled my earlobes to go down and instructed me that you go down.
Dit,
so I went down to the sub building. So whenever I had to go up the stairs, my earlobe was pulled up. And when I reached a room, I was ordered to sit. Then my legs were shackled and the handcuffs were taken off. After I was unblindfolded, I saw the fresh blood nearby. I didn't know which person the blood belonged to.
Oh.
And then later on, they started to interrogate me. They asked me to tell them the truth, how many of us joined the CIA and KGB and
the
NI, my hands together and pleaded them to spare my life, and they told me not to do that to them because they were not monks. And then I told them I did not know any CIA or KGB, and truly I did not know these terms. I heard of them, but I never knew the roles of those people. And then I asked them again to... I use the term Lok or Mister, and using the term Lok resulted in the beatings, like 50 lashes. And then I did not know how I could ask them for forgiveness, so I called them brother. So before I could use the term brother, then I were inflicted with 100 lashes already, and then they started to interrogate me further. One day, while I was being interrogated, and then they were beating me, and then I put my hands up to protect myself, then it broke my fingers. And one day, they removed my nails from the toes, and I was trembling in pain. And later on, about 10 days later, I was electrocuted. It was the rector.
Les électrocutions, ils ont utilisé des câbles électriques
wall attached to the very fresh current, not the one like Deutsch mentioned about electric telephone, something like that. So then I was electrocuted and I could hear some kind of sound in my ears.
And the person who beat me up called contemptible thing. I'm sorry to say contemptible thing. Méprisable.
Ho has a scar on his cheek.
Cicatrice sur
but after my research, I found out that three of them already died.
Que trois d'entre
so
eux
I would like to tell this to Deutsch that Deutsch did not beat me personally directly, otherwise he would not have the day to see the sunlight.
Que,
I just would like to
Duke
be frank.
N'a pas agi directement,
Mr. President,
sinon il ne serait pas encore
Uncle
Chum
Mey,
vivant
please
aujourd'hui.
Be well behaved and make sure that you be more ethical and try to avoid attacking any individual because it is more about the legal proceedings, and the trial chamber appreciates your time to come to testify before us, and that
témoigner devant
you
nous
should refrain from being
veuillez éviter
so unkind to those people that we know that the senior leaders of Khmer Rouge or people during the Khmer Rouge regime, and we would like you to try your best to tell us the truth, and of course the chamber will use your testimony as evidence in our decision, so let's leave it for the chamber to make the final judgment. So could you please proceed further with your
je vous invite à poursuivre votre
story,
récit.
And you can keep talking until the telling us until the country was liberated by
votre récit moment où
support
le pays
of the Vietnamese
a été
troops.
Libéré,
so please tell us more about it. Especially the condition when you were detained at S21 and also the situation when you left S21 and returned to Phnom Penh.
De la période entre le moment où vous avez quitté S21 et vous êtes revenu à Phnom Penh.
I think if I am not telling the truth, I'm afraid that your honors
si
would not
vérité,
be experienced the real taste of
Madame
such
Monsieur
a story, because when I was sent inside, there was no cool method,
ce qui s'est passé parce
and
que, derogatory remarks were used to me, like the motherfucker, like the contemptible, this and that were used. And Ho, Comrade Ho, rolled up his shirt sleeves and then beat me up with several sticks. And then he claimed that I did not confess. That's why I would be beaten more. And I would like to tell your honors the real account, what I have remembered. If I'm not telling the truth, then it would not be good to be here. The President, thank you very much, Mr. Chum Mey, for your testimony. But when you stated something that is about the, for example, you referred to Deutsche, that if Deutsche beat you during the interrogation, then he would not live today. So I think this is not really appropriate to say so in the court. Of course, the court really values your testimony, and we would like you just to refrain from being abusive to insulting the accused or other individual, and we only would like you to refrain from using some terms that we view that not appropriate. So you can please continue.
Ne sont pas à propos.
Mr. Chum Mey.
Poursuivez. Le témoin.
Later on, I was
un peu plus tard,
beaten up for a period of 12 nights and 12 days. So I would be beaten days and nights. At 7 p.m. I would be taken to the south building, to the top floor,
and I was walked
to the place where there was a generator, and then I stepped
et ensuite
on the lying log and then they hold me by my hand, scolded me for being blinded, that I could not see anything, and walked like that. So my earlobes hurt so much because they pulled them up and down almost every day. So regarding the food, they gave us a very thin gruel. And at 1 p.m. they would come back and take me to be interrogated and beaten up again to ask me about the CIA and KGB, although I kept saying that I did not know anything about them. They kept asking me for them.
At 12 p.m.,
one of the guards came and
told
me
est venu me voir pour prendre l'interprète
to let them know, to tell me to let them know that I had to ask permission if I would like to change to a side when I was sleeping. Otherwise, they would perceive that I try to unbreak the chain.
And then he
came and asked who was the guy who is from Orsay, and whether he could fix sewing machine. So then I said I could. Then he said, okay, good, tomorrow then you could work on the fixing the sewing machine, but try not to escape, otherwise you would be shot. Then I said I would not escape, and then they gave me a set of clothes, and I started to work at the workshop. And then they... there was a stack of clothes,
une pile de
and they asked me to help take look after the fire that they used to cook the gruel. And then after the gruel was offered to the other people, then I was allowed to eat the remaining. And then I tried to make use of the remaining of the gruel to complement my hunger. And that they asked me not to let brothers know about this, otherwise I would be beaten up.
Then I met Mr.
Peck.
Et ensuite,
and Peck worked with me in the former regime as a mechanic,
we did not talk to one another. On ne se parlait pas l'un l'autre. On n'osait pas se parler.
And we would work to fix the sewing machines, about 30 sewing machines. Then they asked whether I could fix the typewriter.
Et ensuite, on m'a demandé
and
si
then
je
I said I could, so I fixed two typewriters for them. And later on, I was asked to fix the plumbing machine. So I said I could fix all kinds of machines. So later on, they asked me to teach a female.
The
woman to know about this. And one day I heard the sound of the planes.
Plus tard, j'ai entendu le son
and 3 days later,
un bruit d'avion. Et 3 jours plus tard,
the guards prepared some vests, you know, with ammunition and weapons. At the beginning, they were not prepared, but after hearing the sound, like the bomb drops from the planes, that's why these people were prepared. And later on, we heard the sound of a tank rolling from and we heard the bombardments.
And
then one guy was on a motorbike who told us that the situation was not good and they asked us to go back home. But I was very frustrated because I did not know where I would go.
Peck
went into the workshop where one nat was painting and the rest also entered the room. I was the last person to go to that room, and then I was scolded like the motherfucker why I was so late. I arrived there, and there were two young children, and I asked them. I asked a woman whose these children belong to. They said they were the sons of grandfather Cheng An.
And then I left. Et après cela, je suis parti.
While we were inside the room, we saw
à l'intérieur de la pièce,
four of them with a hand grenade in their hands. And I tried to hide myself to protect myself from being hurt by the grenade if it is exploded. So then when we left the building, we noticed that the tanks already left to the east, but we were walked at gunpoint and they asked us not to run away. They asked us to walk, and then we went into our villa for a long period of time before they asked us to move to the Chinese embassy, and then we moved to Wat San Sam Sal, and we still heard the airplanes and aerial bombardments.
Nous entendions toujours pendant tout ce temps-là les bombardements aériens.
We were walked to Chum Ka Dong,
nous avons marché vers Chum
and I think I got lost probably because we were sitting somewhere like at Bang Chung
Aik, and I could smell
something, and then we went to pray I saw it was so quiet at Présor, and at dawn we proceeded further, and then we reached Ang Snul at about 7 a.m. And I saw my family, my wife. I did not know how she was sent to Présor, and I saw other few other women at that melon watermelon plantation. Then I asked them if I could carry my child, and we walked to the other side of the road. And while we were crossing the road, a Vietnamese CMC truck. People on the truck shot at us, and then we were separated. And Beck and Van Nat returned while we were proceeding ahead with Dipon, the dentist, to Arm Lang. And they already ran away from us, and no one was guarding us. There were only three of us left, Ta Eng from Kampong Cham and my family. So altogether, there were three people who walked far behind the other. And then we went to
Pagoda,
and we asked the people there if we could have some rice so that we can cook them and eat. Then we saw about 50 Khmer Rouge soldiers at Srahtol Pagoda, and they asked us where we were from, and I said we were from the sewing unit, and they asked where we were originally from. We said that we were from the east, and then they said, okay, stay here for a while and wait until we got the letters from the Anka, then we would proceed further. I think it was about at 12 p.m. at night, or maybe 10 p.m., the soldiers left us, and one militia was armed and was seen walking around us. And then there were another three people with AK-47 who came and asked where were the three people to be killed, and the militia said, well, they were still lying down there. And then I woke up, and then they told us that now we got the letter from Anka that we could move further, and they asked the women to walk ahead first because women tend to walk slower than men. Then we left the pagoda. About 1 kilometer from the pagoda during our journey, they opened fire on my family, and during the night with a full moon, then my wife told me to run away because they opened fire on us. Then Ta Eng was also shot at, and Ta Eng collapsed, and he told me while being collapsing, actually he asked me to run away because the soldier was shooting at us. Then after a moment of quietness, then I hit myself near the termite mound, and they could not find us. I could hear some people saying that the guy was hiding near that termite mound, but actually I had escaped to a nearby location already. I would have been killed if I was near the mound. Then I ran further and entered a jungle. And at night, I started to run again.
Dans une zone de jungle, et j'ai la nuit, je me suis caché.
And then,
puis,
at dawn, we would hide ourselves in the jungle, only to proceed further when dark came.
Caché
Then I met a woman. I asked her whether we reached Thmatpong. Then I was told that Thmatpong was far behind us. Now we reached Om Leang. And I knew that Om Leang would not be the best location because those people told us that we would be sent to Om Leang. So I tried to come back. And I had not had any water. I was so thirsty, and we went without water for a few days. And then we reached Poum village near Thmatpong, and we told, we asked other people whether we are reaching Om Leang. And they told us we are close. So only when I could get to Thmatpong that I could recognize where I could come back to Phnom Penh. So a lot of other people were evacuated and driven away by the soldiers. So I was carrying a machete a long knife. And then I tried to cut sugar cane
to substitute
the water that I had been very thirsty for quite a long time. And then we walked further.
Et and ensuite, nous avons poursuivi notre marche
Dan
pour
Roy
arriver à Knar village.
We met about 15 soldiers, and we saw that a group of villagers was still under their control. Then I walked toward them, and with a machete, I knew for sure that whatever happened, I would try to defend myself with the whip.
Quoi qu'il arrive, j'essaierai de me défendre avec cette arme.
I reached a location called Snow. I cheated that I came to see my child, but actually the child was not there. It was just a pretext.
Then
later on I met my family. I met the woman who worked at the sewing unit with my wife, and then we worked together to collect rice to
put
them in the barn. And then I hide again in the barn. At that time, I was so scared of the Vietnamese. And we lived in Bac Chan for some time. I was called to attend a meeting, and I went together with other people, and then I asked if I could become a soldier, and they said no, and then I said if I could be recruited as a soldier, I would be deployed at Phrat Thol, but they said no.
Recruté comme soldat, je serais déployé à Srak Nol.
The president, when the Khmer Rouge
d'aller là-bas,
employed you
le président,
to work
lorsque les Khmer Rouge vous employé pour travailler à Phnom Penh,
what happened to your wife?
Qu'est-il advenu de
votre
femme?
Was she reunited with you in Phnom Penh?
Est-ce que vous avez été réuni avec vous, est-ce qu'elle a été réunie avec vous à Phnom Penh?
Mr. Chum Mey, they allowed her to come to live near Chrang Chom Re to work in the production unit there.
Pour travailler à la production.
Then, when I was sent to Orissay,
lorsqu'on m'a envoyé à Orissay,
I asked them if I could have my family together, work together near me. So my family was sent as request to live or to work near Orissay.
The president,
do you know who made the decision to arrest you? Especially the person who issued such decision. You know who he was? Mr. Chum Mey, I guess donner before un tel ordre. I was arrested.
Réponse. Avant
there was Mr. Kun who was in charge of the sewing unit. Kun was already arrested and his subordinate grandfather Chum was the president. And later on Chum was arrested and then comrade Yong was promoted to be the chief. Then he told me that in Ratanagiri he was looking after the baby elephant for Pol Pot. At that time he burned down the bridge which links to Bokkaw area, and I was the one who was part in fixing that burned down bridge, but I did not tell him about this. Later on, after comrade Yong was arrested, there was another woman from southwest, comrade Wan, with dark complexion. And then there was comrade Lin who came to work with comrade Wan. Wan and Lin were the two people who made the decision to arrest me and send to
Tuol Slang.
The president, when you were arrested, what charges were you told during the democratic Cambodia regime?
Qui vous ont été reprochés sous ce régime du Cambodge démocratique?
The interpreter could not hear Mr. Chum Mey.
L'interprète n'a pas pu entendre Monsieur
the President, when le you président, were sent to lorsque security office of S21, were you sent directly to that office or were you sent to another location when people were waiting to receive you before you were ultimately sent to S21, now known as Tuol Slang prison?
Avez-vous été envoyé dans un lieu de transit avant d'être envoyé à Tuol Slang?
When I arrived, there were no people to receive us because people stormed us and had me handcuffed immediately. And I, during midway, asked them to look after my family, only to learn that they kicked me until I collapsed.
Et ils m'ont donné des coups et je suis tombé à terre.
You said, Mr. President, that you were arrested along with other people, altogether three of you, and that later on you were unfolded. And you were stripped off and then handcuffed. And then detained. What about the other three people? Were they treated the same like the way you were treated?
Est-ce qu'elles ont subi le même traitement que
Chum Mey, I didn't know about them. I knew only about myself.
Moi, je ne savais pas ce qui s'est passé pour
we
aux
want
autres.
To know when you were sent in the three of you. So
moi.
When you were photographed and when you were asked about your biography and when the clothes were taken off and they cuffed were uncuffed, what happened to the other two? Were they in the same way?
Lorsque on vous a
enlevé
les
menottes,
qu'est-ce qui vous est arrivé? L'interprète n'a pas entendu la réponse du témoin.
Uncle, please be mindful with the microphone button. You need to turn on the button so that the interpreter could hear and could interpret for the international audience and parties
des étrangers.
So before you speak, please you switch on your microphone
de brancher votre
first.
Micro avant de parler.
Chẳng ông bê đai khi bị chun ông lắm.
So when you were
question
put into the center, you were put into an individual cell where you were by yourself. Is
this
correct?
Dans une pièce où vous étiez seul au départ,
that is correct.
Réponse, oui, c'est exact.
President.
Question.
You talked in details regarding the treatment by the S21 staff on you from the time that you entered
à partir du moment où vous êtes entré
the detention office of S21, the interrogation together with the torture.
Et vous dites que vous avez été interrogé
in the form of a hot method
torture à l'appui
was done on you
chaude.
Consecutively for 12 days, 12 nights. Is that correct?
12 nuits consécutives.
That is correct, Mr. President.
Oui, Monsieur le Président, c'est exact.
Question. You also stated that you were beaten up with a
vous avez aussi
whip
dit que
or with a stick during the interrogation.
Frappé à coups de fouet et de bâton pendant les interrogatoires.
And because they wanted you to use the actual proper words that they used, but because you did not use
parce
the correct words, then you were beaten with 100 lashes. What do you mean by you were beaten for 100 lashes? What type of stick or whip was it?
De bâton.
Can you describe?
Pouvez-vous nous dire plus précisément comment vous étiez porté ces coups?
Mr. President, there were bamboo sticks.
Il y avait des cannes de bambou.
There were like rattan sticks or tree branches the size of a thumb. And at that time, at the corner, I saw a whole bunch of those sticks
tout un tas
for
de ces
used to whip or hit on the prisoner.
Pour, frapper les prisonniers.
Question. When you were beaten during the interrogation,
pendant ces passages à
were you sitting or were you lying with your face down on the floor?
Ou est-ce que vous étiez allongé sur le sol, visage face vers
I
le
was,
sol?
I was sitting and my leg was shackled.
Mes jambes étaient entravées.
President, so you were asked to sit directly on the floor or on
vous étiez assis
a chair
par terre ou assis sur
when
une
you
chaise
were being interrogated.
Pendant les interrogatoires.
To my
réponse.
I was ordered to sit directly on the floor with my
sol,
legs straight.
Avec les jambes allongées.
President,
question.
Besides the stick, that's the word you use.
En dehors de ces
because
cannes,
in your previous document, you used the word club, which is different from a stick. Now you talk about a stick.
Dans vos dépositions.
Probably the difference is the size
stick,
or the types of the
bâton, canne,
or the material used.
Cela dépend sur
so I think that the main difference
utilisé.
Between the stick and
moi,
the clap is
the
size. What about the subsequent
utilisé?
Torture? What types of tools were used on you?
De torture qui ont été utilisés contre vous?
I was not beaten with a clap, but I was beaten with a stick. It's about the size of
j'étais
a thumb.
Battu
and when one was broken,
de pouce,
they used another one.
Rompu,
and
romper,
my question is, that type of torture,
question.
How many
je
times did it happen when you were tortured during your interrogation
de fois vous avez été torturé
with the use of the stick and that you were Your nails were also pulled, and you were also electrocuted.
La torture infligée à l'aide de ces
cannes. So I want to know specifically the different types of torture. Regarding the sticks, how many times?
Je voudrais savoir combien de fois vous avez été torturé pour chacune
de ces
méthodes.
They used the sticks to beat me after every single day during that period. They always had a bunch of the sticks ready at the corner of a table.
Prêt dans un coin.
And on that table, they had a typewriter on it.
Il y avait une machine.
And a bunch of sticks just laying nearby. So after I was interrogated and beaten. Then the person came back to type, and after that, the same process continued. So they always had a bunch of sticks ready near the table where they put the typewriter on.
À proximité de la table où se trouvait la machine à écrire.
The president.
Question.
When they interrogated you, what was the main focus of the interrogation? What did they want from you during that interrogation?
Savoir de vous?
Chum Mey, at that time, they asked me about the KGB and CIA. That was the main focus, nothing else. And if we answered about other things, then I would be beaten. And if I talked about Cambodia crown, for example, I would not allow. They would beat me up.
Non, c'était interdit, on me frappait.
The president.
Question.
And on which sessions that during that interrogation that your toenails were pulled?
Quand
on which
vous
day?
A-t-on arraché les ongles? Quel jour?
May. I cannot recall the exact day.
Pas du jour exact.
However, talking about the nail pulling, I think it was about 1 week into that period of interrogation.
À peu près une semaine après que les interrogatoires.
The president. So it means you were beaten and tortured for interrogation. And during the process of that torture, about a week later,
et que
your nails were pulled.
Après une semaine environ de ce régime,
can you describe clearly?
Est-ce que vous pouvez nous
details,
décrire plus en détail la manière dont on vous a arraché les ongles
during that interrogation? To my, Mr.
Réponse.
President, the beating with the stick was on a daily basis. They had a
Monsieur
bunch of the sticks ready.
De cannes, c'était tous les jours. Ils avaient toute une
so
série de cannes prêtes
I raised my left hand to defend myself, and one of my fingers was broken.
Levé la main pour me protéger. C'est ainsi qu'on m'a cassé un doigt.
But because I kept the same response that I did not know anything about the KGB or the CIA, then they used a plier to twist my toenail, and because it was not pulled out, then the person pulled out my toenail. The president. So they did not have to use any extra equipment because your legs were already shackled, so they used a pinch or a plier to squeeze on your toenail. And then they pulled it out. Did they nail detach?
Est-ce que l'ongle
Mr. President, yes, the nail was completely
réponse.
Detached
oui,
from my toe.
Complètement arraché.
They twisted the nail with the plier, and because the nail
pince,
did not come out, so they pulled out.
Pas, ils ont tiré.
You meant the entire nail was pulled out, or only just part of the nail
une partie de l'ongle
was pulled out? Asked the president. Chum Mey, Mr. President, actually it's the entire nail was detached.
Réponse. L'ongle
from
tout
the toe.
A été arraché.
Did the nail grow? Asked the president.
Est-ce que l'ongle a repoussé?
Mr. Chum Mey, yes,
réponse.
But it was not informity, it was deformed.
Oui, mais
it grew back, but it was deformed.
L'ongle a repoussé, mais il est déformé.
Mr. President, can you show us that nail or
est-ce
that
vous
toe
pouvez nous montrer
with a deformed
cet ongle qui est maintenant déformé?
That's a bit it. The interpreter cannot hear the witness.
tiếng pi ở trong song khang này.
Chú mến
tại mê chương đi.
Les interprètes n'entendent pas le témoin qui ne parle pas dans un micro.
The toes from on both feet were pulled out, asked the president.
Le président a posé la question de savoir si les ongles étaient arrachés aux deux pieds.
Camera,
the AB unit, can you zoom into the toes of the witness?
Techniciens peuvent nous donner une image des pieds
you
de la partie civile.
Go back to the table. Thank you. Says the president.
Je vous remercie, monsieur. Vous pouvez reprendre place à la barre.
The
president. So when they tortured you, they use a plier to squeeze and pull out your nails.
Pour tordre les ongles et
they
les arracher.
Did on both.
Et ils l'ont fait.
The both toes of your feet. Is that correct?
Pieds, si je vous comprends bien.
Yes, that is correct. Says Chum Mey. The toe pulling.
Question.
Was it done?
Est-ce que
just in one session, or was it done in a subsequent session as well?
Lors d'une séance de torture seulement, ou lors de plusieurs séances?
On one day, one side of the
un jour, on m'a fait
nails were pulled, and the other side was pulled on the next day.
Les ongles d'un côté, et puis un autre jour de l'autre côté.
The president.
Question.
When you were interrogated with torture in a form of electrocution,
vous avez aussi été torturé,
how many times did they electrocute you?
Combien de fois cela s'est-il passé?
To my Mr. President, I was electrocuted twice and I failed unconscious for both times.
Les deux fois.
The president,
question.
You stated that the electrocution was not in the same form as stated by the accused, that is, without using the dynamo winding manually, but actually the electricity was a full current, 220 volts, from the volt outlet.
Volts qui venait de la prise.
That is the normal voltage used in the office, is that correct?
La tension normale
so they used the one wire to put into your ear?
Est-ce qu'il
yes, one wire was pulled,
réponse, oui.
Put into my ear,
on m'a mis un fil
says Chum Mey, and when I fell unconscious, they pulled
et
the wire out.
Quand j'ai perdu connaissance, ils ont retiré le fil électrique.
The president, the
question.
Accused said, the method
l'accusé
of electrocution was only in the form of manual winding dynamo, but in
dynamo
real practice, the interrogator
mais
actually used
réelle,
the
que les
current,
the en
the voltage from the volt outlet.
Le courant électrique
but
from
what the accused says, the original plan was to use the manually winding dynamo.
Alors
but then if
dynamo.
The volt outlet was used by the interrogator, probably was done by the interrogators and
alors,
without his knowledge.
Le courant normal, et c'était peut-être à l'insu de l'accusé.
My next question to you is that during the times that you
suivante,
were tortured, for example,
torturé,
when you were
par exemple,
beaten up with a lot of lashes, or when your nails were pulled out, or when you were electrocuted, a moment after the torture, did they have any medic to fix your wound?
Est-ce que vous receviez des soins après la torture?
No, there was no medic to come and check up on me. I could even hardly walk.
Je pouvais à peine marcher.
You said on the 7th of January 1979 at 11 a.m. the situation was changed. So you gathered together with other survivors and left the location and the threat by the armed guards to walk in line.
Vous avez reçu instruction des gardes de
and the question is, first,
ma question, tout d'abord,
how many survivors, or at that time, how many prisoners
de prisonniers
were there who walked along with you at gunpoint,
ont ainsi quitté les yeux,
leaving
les lieux,
the S21 office toward Tul Tumpung and Preso and other locations as you described? How many of you were all together and were you cuffed?
Est-ce que vous aviez les mains liées?
Mr. President,
réponse.
I did not count the actual number, but there were more than 10 of us.
Mais nous étions une dizaine.
They did not cuff us.
Et nous
we
pas
could
liées.
Walk freely, but they pointed the guns at us.
Les gardes nous maintenaient en joue.
The president.
Question.
How many of you?
Combien étiez-vous?
There were about 15 of us, Mr. President.
15, Monsieur le Président.
The president, when you left,
question.
From the time that you left,
entre le moment
and while you were in the forest or while you were lost in the forest or during your journey,
dans la forêt.
Did you ever meet the accused?
Est-ce que vous avez jamais rencontré l'accusé?
I never met him. Even if
non,
I met him, I would not recognize him.
Même si je l'avais vu, je l'aurais pas reconnu.
The president.
Réponse. Question, pardon.
Can you recall the day that T came to look for the sewing machine repairer or mechanic? You know the date?
Est venu chercher les mécaniciens
pour réparer les
machines à coudre.
President, when he came to ask about that matter, I was no longer interrogated, so they came to look for me at the detention cell.
Et donc c'est dans la cellule
the President,
que
so you were interrogated for 12 days and 12 nights, and after that they stopped interrogating you.
Après quoi les interrogatoires ont stoppé?
And what was the reason for stopping the interrogation?
Ces interrogatoires ont cessé.
They stopped
réponse.
Interrogating me.
On a arrêté de m'interroger.
Because I confessed
parce
that I joined the CIA and the KGB.
CIA
it was
KGB.
Due to my confession.
C'est grâce à mes aveux
the president.
Que ça a
why did they believe your confession?
Pourquoi ont-ils cru vos aveux?
Did you implicate other people?
Est-ce que vous avez,
because
mis
in the form of interrogation on the biography and then your personal activities
dû,
and then the activities of your network.
Dire or
the treacherous network,
mais vous avez aussi dû
and that was a part of the structure of the confession.
C'était comme cela que les aveux
was
étaient
the form of the interrogation on you
et est-ce
in
que
a similar way, talking
cas,
about your own activities and the activities of your network.
De vos propres activités et des agissements de votre réseau
Mr.
de traître.
President,
réponse.
I confess that I did
oui,
join the CIA or the KGB, but actually it was a fabrication because I was beaten so severely, so I just implicated other people.
J'ai mis en cause d'autres personnes.
The President.
Le président.
We understand on the truthfulness of the confession, but we
nous
wanted to know about whether after the confession was extracted, then they stopped torturing you. So they interrogated you, and then you made a false confession that you acknowledge that you are part of a CIA or KGB network with your own
traitorous
network.
Vous avez reconnu
and you just use names of various other people in order to avoid being tortured.
Pour échapper
is that correct?
À la torture, est-ce exact?
That is a very
réponse.
Correct,
oui,
Mr. President.
Vrai, Monsieur le Président.
The President,
question.
You entered as 21. Do you recall the date?
Est-ce que vous vous souvenez de la date à laquelle vous êtes arrivé à S21?
Chum Mey. Réponse. I entered on the 28th of October 1978.
À S21, le 28 octobre 1978.
President.
Question.
From the 28th of October 1978, besides the experience of what you encountered regarding the treatment on you by the S21 security staff,
vous avez été infligé par le personnel de S21.
Did you observe the general situation? In this office,
quelle était la situation
for example,
générale au centre de détention.
The condition of the detention, the torture, or any other situation that you might have observed.
Personne était torturée.
Chum Mey, Mr. President, besides myself,
réponse.
The rest. One day when I was fixing the sewing machine.
Un jour, alors que j'étais en train de réparer des machines à coudre.
A person was three people were carried behind my back to be buried
j'ai vu que
near the one big
on emmenait trois
tree.
Corps pour les enterrer près d'un gros arbre.
The president,
question.
Did you ever see any
Est-ce
torture being done on other prisoners?
De torture
to
dont
no,
d'autres
I did not,
victimes.
But I could hear the
non,
screaming.
J'entendais les cris.
The president, did you ever see the
Question.
Accused?
Est-ce que vous avez jamais vu l'accusé?
Committing any torture on any other people during your detention there?
Durant votre détention.
No, I did not see
non.
That. The president,
Question.
Because you said you not even knew the accused at the time, right?
Vous dites que vous ne connaissiez pas l'accusé à l'époque, n'est-ce pas?
The president,
Question.
When you were released to go and repair the sewing machines.
Quand on
besides repairing the sewing machines, you were also asked to repair a generator.
On vous a aussi demandé de réparer un générateur.
Oh, was it a water pump?
Ou
so then you were asked to repair a water pump.
On vous a demandé de réparer
so during
une
that time, at night.
Et à ce moment-là.
So let's first ask about your working hours.
De nuit, je crois. Je voudrais
to
commencer
my,
par vous demander
Mr.
quelles étaient vos horaires de travail.
The working
Réponse.
Hours were non-stop.
L'horaire
there
de
was
travail,
no rest.
C'était jour et nuit, il n'y a pas de repos.
What do you mean,
Question.
People? If people work without non-stop, probably died after one week.
Si on travaille non-stop, on
so how many sessions
vite,
did you work? Day, night, or day, afternoon, and night shift?
Matin, après-midi, par pause, le soir.
Jumai.
Réponse.
When I was allowed to work in the back,
Quand
I worked in two sessions.
À l'arrière, je faisais deux
in the morning,
pauses.
I worked from morning until 4 p.m. and I only stopped for
a
meal.
Et je ne m'arrêtais que pour prendre un repas.
The president, and at night,
Question.
Where did
soir,
they allow you to sleep?
Où est-ce que vous dormez? Réponse.
At night, I was taken to the
le
upper
soir,
floor, to the very top floor.
Tout au-dessus.
And I was put in those long shackles, so I slept along with the in a stack of other people.
Avec d'autres.
I slept with Tatoon, the dentist.
Tatoon, le dentiste.
The president.
Question.
So it meant even if you were allowed to work. To fix the sewing machine or the water pump at night time after you finished your work, after your evening meal, then you were taken to the second floor in the
étage,
common room,
dans une
and you were shackled in a long bar
as
other prisoners, right?
En compagnie d'autres prisonniers.
That is correct, Mr. President.
Réponse, oui.
We were shackled during
nous
the entire night, and in the morning I was unshackled,
matin,
and then I went to work.
On m'a emmené travailler. Question.
What about the incident that you saw two children while you were working there?
Concernant des enfants.
You said you saw the two
vous
children there already, or you only saw the two children only on the last day,
mais
that is the 7th of January
1979? Dernier jour, le 7 janvier 1979.
Hein? Mr. President,
réponse.
Those two children, from what I could say,
que j'en sais.
They went to the location at the back for about 1 month. In the morning, they went there. So I looked at them and I asked the comrade Sok, who was cooking there, whose children, and I was told they belonged to Ta Jae-on. So I stopped asking questions.
Après ça, je n'ai plus posé de questions.
The President, did you know
question.
The fate of what happened to
est-ce
the two children?
Vous savez ce que ces deux enfants sont devenus?
You may know I
réponse.
Did not.
Non.
However, when I mais went inside and when the gate was closed, the two children were there, left,
que j'allais à l'intérieur,
where
que
they cooked
l'intérieur,
the food. The President, before you
là.
Left, did you observe that within the compound of S21 were there any other remaining prisoners?
D'autres prisonniers encore qui restaient à S21.
Chum Mey, Mr. President.
Réponse.
From what I could estimate, there was no remaining prisoner. Maybe only those two children
peut-être uniquement ces deux enfants
remained.
Qui sont restés.
I later on heard that the two children stayed amongst the pile of clothes.
Ses enfants étaient
the President,
restés cachés
I want to know about the remaining soldiers. Were there any other prisoners
des soldats
remained,
des
or the noise from them that make you to conclude that there would be some other prisoners?
Est-ce qu'il y avait des bruits qui vous aura pu vous indiquer qu'il y
no,
avait des
I
gens
did not,
au
Mr.
camp?
President, because réponse, when I left,
non.
I left.
Quand je suis parti.
The President,
question.
When did you return to Prison Security Office after the deliberation day of 7 January 1979?
Quand êtes-vous arrivé à Prison après le 7 janvier 79, jour de la libération?
To my, Mr. President,
réponse.
Could you please ask again?
Est-ce que vous pouvez répéter votre question, s'il vous plaît?
The President,
question.
After your trip to Om Leang, after
vous
you got lost,
Leang,
and
perdu,
later on you met your current wife,
vous avez rencontré votre
and that you tried to hide from the
et
Vietnamese soldiers, I want to know when
et j'aimerais savoir quand
did you return
vous êtes
to that location again at S21 or Tools Lane?
S21
May, Mr. President.
Réponse.
At that time, I was working with the transport section in Odam. It was several months later
déjà plusieurs mois plus
when
tard,
Mr. Ng Pek
quand
called
Pek
me to make a movie
pour un film.
And the photographs. So altogether, there were only seven of us.
Nous étions sept.
And I asked why they needed to photograph us.
J'ai demandé pourquoi vous
I was told that it was for the purpose of giving to an international organization.
Pour redonner à une organisation internationale.
And that the previous photos taken by the German group was not believed by the United
parce
Nations.
Que les Nations
so the German
Unies
team came again and found the seven of us, took our photos, and later on it was believed by the UN.
Photo, que les Nations Unies
the
ont
President.
Accepté.
Thank you, Uncle.
Question.
It
merci,
is now
monsieur.
Time to taken adjournment. So we will adjourn for 20 minutes and resume at 10 to 11. The court official, could you please help make sure that the witness is taken to his waiting room?
La partie civile puisse aller à la salle d'attente.